So do you need a computer or a laptop? Let's talk about that. In this video, we're going to see how you can select the best computer or laptop for your needs without breaking the bank. This is already the third video of my free 6-part VFX training series, so if you haven't seen the first two, be sure to check those out first.
If you want access to all 6 videos, then click the link in the description below.
We've talked about laying a good foundation in order to create epic VFX. A good foundation is also your equipment, because your VFX are unfortunately as good as your equipment. Obviously, when you're starting out, it's not as important. You can definitely do VFX on most type computers, but with the right specifications, you're going to have faster speeds and therefore you're going to evolve faster as a VFX artist because you're seeing your results quicker and smoother. It's not going to crash as much, it's not gonna lag as much, so I think you get the point. That said, you've definitely come to the right place if you want to learn VFX the right way or if you just want to improve your workflow or become more efficient at it. The goal of this video is to make you understand what to look for when you're looking for a computer. The first and most important question you should ask yourself is whether you want a laptop or a computer. If you want to travel the world or just not be specifically set to one location, a laptop is definitely a good choice. Laptops nowadays are definitely not a problem to create epic VFX. But if you have a studio or a place that you're always going to be at and you know you're going to be there most of the time, I would definitely encourage you to get a computer. Computers just tend to be a little bit more stable, also have a better airflow for the heat because VFX is quite heavy on your system, and just all around I do think it's just a little bit better nowadays, especially if you have a great computer. It's just the choice between a computer or laptop of the same budget, usually the computer will be better. Another reason why you might consider a laptop is because cloud computing is becoming a thing. This literally means that your specifications of your system don't really matter that much anymore. The only thing that matters is your internet connection, so you can log in on your cloud system and do your VFX on a cloud computer. Let's talk about the specifications and what they do in VFX. I would definitely encourage you to look for a computer with an SSD drive. SSD drives are responsible for your software startup times and for your file transfers within. So when you have your software installed on an SSD and you have your project files, such as your video footage, on an SSD, it's going to write a lot faster to your video editing software, therefore making your video editing workflow or VFX workflow a lot more efficient and a lot faster. Another very important thing is your graphics card, and it's really upcoming. Before, the processor was the most important thing when it came to rendering and VFX, but nowadays everything is becoming more and more optimized for a GPU or graphics card. So having a good graphics card is definitely recommended. So for graphics card, you have many choices. I've always used an Nvidia graphics card and found that very useful. So an RTX 1080 is definitely advised as a minimum, in my opinion. But you can try to go lower than that if that's the case for you. If you can go higher, like a 2080 or a 3080, it's always going to improve your workflow even more. So a good graphics card is kind of essential in VFX workflows. So we talked about the SSD and about the graphics card. Your processor is a next important thing. Most things are being optimized for your graphics card, but until now, not everything is optimized for the graphics card. So having a good processor is also important. Here, the more cores is not necessarily the better. I would advise something between 4 cores or more, but what really matters is your hertz. If you have a 3.5 gigahertz processor, that means it's going to render a lot faster than a 2.5. So having high hertz is just going to allow the performance of your processor to work more efficient for VFX. So look at that last number of your processor. And then lastly, we have the RAM. So the RAM is where all the cache files or the project files while you're working on a project will be stored on. The more RAM you have, the smoother that will be. For VFX, it's really recommended not to go lower than 16 gigabytes of RAM. If you do have lower, you can still manage to do VFX. I'm not saying that this is necessary, but it's just going to give you a much more pleasant experience. Obviously, again here, if you go higher in the number, the more efficient you become. 32 gigabytes is a very normal number in the VFX industry, and 64 becomes in a more professional system. And then we also have a 128 gigabytes of RAM if you want to have have a really professional system. You can go even over that, but again, it's not necessary. 32 would be a great buy, 16 gigabytes would be my minimum. So if you want to have a kind of budget-friendly computer that is a super beast when it comes to VFX, then 32 gigabytes with an RTX 2080 could be a great option. Just make sure you have an SSD card installed where you will install your software and project files on, and then you're good to go. So now you know exactly what type of computer to look for when you want to create VFX. In the next video, I will show you the exact tools you need in order to create epic VFX in the most efficient way possible and without feeling overwhelmed. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for the next one, because your journey to become a VFX artist has just only started. Until the next one, create epic videos.
If you want access to all 6 videos, then click the link in the description below.